हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सो इन टुडेज़ वीडियो वी विल टेक फिटिंग एंड रिलेटेड रिएक्शन। इट इज़ चैप्टर नंबर 2 एंड इट्स पार्ट 4। सो वी आर गोइंग टू टेक फर्स्ट व्हाट इज़ विटिंग रिएक्शन एंड देन वी विल टेक द मॉडिफिकेशंस व्हिच हैज़ बीन डन इन विटिंग रिएक्शन, राइट? सो विटिंग रिएक्शन इज़ बेसिकली रिएक्शन ऑफ एल्डिहाइड और कीटोन्स विथ फॉस्फोनियम एलाइड्स। So I am just writing down allide here, but it is reacting with phosphonium allide, right? And they will give us alkene. So this is the general outcome of this reaction, that it will give us alkene. And when you have hindered structure of aldehyde or ketone, or you have hindered allides, means when you have hindered structures, then formation of alkene is not easy, right? So we need HMPA for this reaction and then the reaction will go easily. HMPA is hexamethylene phosphoramide, right? It is used to increase rate of reaction. So first we will take what is the general its reaction mechanism. So suppose I have a ketone here and it will react with phosphonium allide. Phosphonium allide is formed by the reaction of triphenyl phosphine and alkyl halides in presence of your lithium bases, like generally butyl lithiums and LDAs are used. So it will give you allide like this. Allide is means when you have negative and positively charged atoms adjacent to each other. We have negative charge on carbon and positive charge on phosphorus, so it is phosphonium allide. This allide can also be written down like this, right? We can also write down it like this, double bond form. So what will happen, this negative charge will act as a nucleophile, so it will attack on this carbonyl carbon, which is electrophilic in nature, right? So when it will attack on this, suppose this is my carbon, these two R will go like this, and we have negative charge on oxygen after shifting of this bond. When this negative charge will attack on this carbon, this bond will shift here. We have negative charge on oxygen. Next is, this is my second carbon which attacks on this carbonyl carbon. This is R and this P, this phosphorus will go like this, right? Now this oxygen can attack on this phosphorus, right? This is called oxaphosphatane. This four membered ring is called. Next, what will happen? This bond will shift here and it will shift here. So there is formation of phosphorus double bond oxygen and it is very, very strong bond. So its formation is feasible, right? So what we will get? We will get alkene here. So this is the general mechanism and many of you know about this, right? But we will take very different points which can create problem for us, right? So first point is that if substituent attached on carbonyl are electron withdrawing in nature, we have this type of structure, suppose this one, right? And this is my carbonyl, and on this carbonyl we have here a group. This R is suppose your electron withdrawing group, and if it is electron withdrawing, it will reduce this negative charge. Reduce the negative charge means it will make it more stable. And when it will become more stable, it will become less reactive. Its basic function is that it is acting as a nucleophile, attacking on this electrophilic carbon. But when we will attach an electron withdrawing group next to it, it will withdraw its negative charge from it, make it more stable and less reactive in nature, right? And such type of allide are called stabilized allide, and they will form E-alkene. Next is, when we have this carbon, this is acting as a electrophilic center, right? So when this carbon is more electrophilic, reaction will become more fast, because suppose I have two groups attached here which are electron withdrawing, which is withdrawing electron towards it, making it more electrophilic in nature, then reaction rate will increase. So you can write down that more electrophilic carbonyl react fast, right? For example, I have two examples here, that in which one I have alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde and it is just a ketone, right? and same type of halides are used here. Both are stabilized halide because we have here electron withdrawing group, a ester group attached here. So it will make this carbonyl less reactive, more stable. So it is a stabilized halide. So it should give us e-alkene, right? Then question comes, the reaction will be faster for which out of these two? For this one, because of this double bond at alpha beta position, it will make more electrophilic to this carbon. So what we will get from this reaction? This is my carbonyl group, and after the reaction what will happen? That we will get a new double bond at this position, and the rest part will attach like this, right? Or you can understand that what is the mechanism of this reaction. This is your CHO, and you when you will form a oxaphosphatane, what you will get? That this PPH3 will attach here, and this is your carbonyl carbon, this one, and here I have ester group attached here. So when this bond will break, I will get a double bond at this position, this one. And because it is a stabilized halide, that is why I have formed here e-alkene. And for this one, I will get this. It is also e-alkene. But rate of reaction will be faster for this one. This is more reactive. And this one is less reactive. Third point is, when we have alkyl substituent on carbonyl. So this alkyl substituent will make carbonyl more reactive, or you can say less stable in nature. So it will form unstabilized halide, right? You can have alkyl group attached here, attached on carbonyl, or you can have no substituent present on next to carbonyl. Means there is no group which can stabilize your carbonyl, is also unstabilized carbonyl, right? You have simple carbon chain there. It is also your unstabilized halide. For example, in this case, I have CHO here, so it will participate in reaction. There is no role of all other groups attached here, right? And I have here halide which is stabilized by this ester, so it will form stabilized halide, right? So what type of alkene it will give us? It will give e-alkene. So I will not write down this part. Suppose it is R, this one. So what you will get? This is your carbon CHO, and we will get double bond at this position, right? And ester group will go here to form e-alkene. If I will place this ester at this position, then it will become z-alkene, and we have to make e-alkene only, right? So this will be the major product. Then in next example, I have here this phosphonium salt, and I have the sodium base, right? So this sodium base will remove acidic proton from this position, and it will form halide like this. And this halide is not stabilized by any other electron withdrawing group. It is just attached with carbon chain. That is why I have told you that there is no compulsion that you will have alkyl group attached here. Only in that condition you will get unstabilized halide. If you don't have any other group attached at this position, you just have these carbon chains, then it is also your unstabilized halide, because it is not stabilized by any other electron withdrawing group attached to it. So it will give you Z alkene. So it will react with only with this carbonyl. All other part will remain as such. So again I will write down it as R. So you will get Z-alkene here. Next we come fourth point of this Wittig reaction. So we have seen that if we are using a stabilized halide, then we will get E-alkene, and if we are using unstabilized halide, we will get Z-alkene. So according to that, it is only dependable on your type of halide which is you are using. But other factors also affect the stereochemistry of the reaction, that what type of base you are using. This is also decided by base used. Stereochemistry also decided by the base used. For example, if I want to form Z alkene, then definitely I will use a unstabilized halide. But to generate an unstabilized halide, I have to use sodium or potassium salt. And to form E alkene, lithium salts are used, right? So it is also an important point. Then we will take some different type of reactions based on these Wittig reaction. So here I have this these reagents, and base is given in the reaction. So this halide, if you see at this part of the, if you will use the sodium hydride to generate halide, then this halide will not be stabilized by any other group attached here. So it will be your unstabilized halide. And you can confirm it by this, that when we need to generate unstabilized halide, we have to use the sodium or potassium salts of bases, right? So that is why we are using sodium salt here. So which type of halide it will form? I am just writing down here that it will form a unstabilized halide. So it will directly react with this part of this carbonyl. So you will get double bond here, right? And this MU group will attach here. In addition to that, I have here this H3O plus also, means acidic hydrolysis will also take place. Now the proton present on this water will attack on this oxygen like this. In next step, the water will attack on this carbon and this MuOH will be removed. I will get this one, right? In next step, this H will be removed, and what I will get? OH attached here. I can also write it down like this, right? So you will get this molecule. So it is slightly different because we are doing acidic hydrolysis of it also. Then we have a different type of reaction formed using this Wittig reaction. This reaction is called Corey-Fock reaction. Its mechanism a little bit different. Here we are using tetrabromomethane, triphenylphosphine, right? So what will be the reaction mechanism? You can also write it down it like this. So the lone pair of electron present on this phosphorus will attack on this bromine. This bond will break, right? We will get this one. In next step, this negative charge present on this carbon will attack on this phosphorus, and this bond will shift here, right? Again, one more equivalent of this triphenylphosphine will attack on this Br, and this bond will shift here. So you will get a structure like this. It can also be written in form of halide like this. Now it will attack on this aldehyde. The rest mechanism is similar to the Wittig reaction, right? Next, this bond will break, this will shift here, we will get this one. In next step, we are using this butyl lithium, so this will replace one Br, and we will get here lithium attached, and here I have a Br. In next step, this lithium will attack on this Br, and LiBr will be removed. What I will get here? A carbene. This step little bit different, that you will get a carbene here. I also have a proton attached on this carbon, so it will shift here, and this lone pair of electron will shift here to form a triple bond. So I am writing down the product of this step here, that you will get a triple bond like this. Next, we are using an electrophile, so it will attack on this, you will get electrophile attached. So this part is little bit different. You have to be very careful when you are using this butyl lithium. The rest part is little bit different, right? Then the reaction is very, very simple and very important also from NET exam especially. Then we will take intramolecular Wittig reaction. So this is mechanism is similar to the that we have seen previously. Nothing different, that we are using base here. We can use tertiary butoxide or sodium ethoxide, right? So simply we have to remove a proton from this position. It will form carbenine here, right? Then it will attack on this group. You can write down this amide part like this. So this negative charge will attack on this carbon. This bond will shift here. You can assume this step like this, right? It is like this. In next step, this bond will break, it will shift here, and you will get a double bond at this position. So here is formation of a 5-membered ring like this. Similarly, in this case, this is already in form of halide. You can consider negative charge here and positive charge here. After shifting this bond, you will get one negative charge here, one positive charge here, like this one. Suppose it is your carbenine and it is positive charge. I have simply written down this negative charge in this form, in the form of halide. Next step will be that it will attack on this CHO. I have written down the CHO in this form. Simply it will form a 5-membered ring here like this. Next step will be this bond will shift here. It will shift here. It will form PH3P double bond O, right? And you will get a double bond at this position. It will be like this. This part will be removed and you will get a double bond at this position. Next is, this time we are using a very different type of halide. In halides, you have this type of structure, this one. But we have one H missing here. Halide is basically formed when we are treating this triphenylphosphine with, suppose I have this methyl halide, so it will attack on this, then this X is removed, right? In next step, suppose I am using butyl lithium, so this H will be removed and I will get this structure. Now in this case, this carbonyl compound is, this ketone is very hindered. So this simple type of halide cannot work here. We cannot react it with this one. So we have to use one more equivalent of butyl lithium. So it will remove this one more H from this CH2 also. So we will get this one. How? We can also write down this structure like this, right? So when I will treat it with this butyl lithium, this one H is removed, we will get negative charge here and lithium will attach with this. So we can also write it down it like this. So we will get this one. Now we can react it with this hindered structure and we will get double bond. We will get alkene here like this, right? Next we will take Horner-Wadsworth-Emon reaction. It is modification in Wittig reaction. How this is modified, that we are using here this simple phosphonium halide. This time we will use phosphonate esters. Phosphonate esters, right? And how this phosphonate ester will form, that first we will have to use a alkyl halide, then we will treat it with trialkyl phosphite, then we will get this phosphonate ester. And this step of formation of phosphonate ester, this one is called as Arbus-Job reaction. This part, the use of this phosphonate ester with aldehydes to form alkene is called Horner-Wadsworth-Emon reaction. And the formation of this phosphonate esters is done through this Arbus-Job reaction. So in place of alkyl halide, generally bromoesters are used like this. And trialkyl phosphite is, suppose, your this one, right? So this phosphorus having lone pair of electron will attack on this carbon and this Br will be removed. So we will get this structure first, then this Br will attack on this ethyl group. We can also write down it like this. So this Br released from this step will attack on this ethyl and this bond will shift here. So we will get P double bond O at this position, right? And this is called your phosphonate ester. Now we can use this phosphonate ester for further reaction. I will take this reaction here. Suppose how it can participate in this reaction, that suppose I will use this same phosphonate ester here. First I have to treat it with some base so that I will get a carbonyne at this position. Suppose I am using sodium hydride, we will get negative charges at this position. Now it can attack on carbonyl, ketone or aldehyde. So it will attack on this aldehyde and the same step will take place as we have seen previously. And you will get this carbon and this ester, this part will attach at this position. You will get this one is alkene, right? So we will take many reaction based on this in next few slides. Generally you will get E alkene from this reaction, from this Horner wet salt amine reaction. So general stereochemistry of reaction is that it will give you E-alkene. In next example, again we will take the use of this phosphonate ester, but is this our phosphonate ester? No, it is not in form of phosphonate ester. So first we have to convert it into ester form. That we have here lithium attached, so we can consider that this lithium has some positive charge and it is negative charge. This carbon has negative charge, so this negatively charged carbon will attack on the CO group of this ester. Means I can write down this part, only this part of this molecule like this, and I am going to attack it with this carbon ion. So it will attack on this. This bond will shift here, and when it will come back, this methoxide group will be removed. So I will get here, we will get this structure. In next step, I am using this base. So this base will remove a proton from this position, right? So it, I will get negative charge here. Now it can react with this aldehyde and we will get alkene. So we have to just add, we have to add this group here with one double bond. We need only one double bond at this position, and then I can attach the whole part here, right? So it will give us again E-alkene. So the reaction is almost similar to the Wittig reaction, but just we are using phosphonate esters here. Next thing is stereoselectivity. Or so in Horner-Wedgeworth Amine reaction, we have seen that generally we will get, most of the time we will get E-alkene, but it is not always true that you will get only E-alkene. You cannot say that when you are using a Wittig reaction in case of phosphonium halide, you can easily say that if you have a stabilized halide you will get E-alkene, if you have unstabilized halide you will get Z-alkene. But in this case, in this particular reaction, the stereochemistry is not defined for a particular type of phosphonate esters. Yield is very high and as compared to Wittig reaction, that is why the modifications were done, but stereochemistry is not defined. So if we are using, suppose I have a bulkier group attached, if my phosphonate ester contains bulkier groups, like suppose I have here this isopropyl group attached, right, then in that case I will get E-alkene. But at the same time, if I this CF3CH2O group, it is also not very small size, but it will give me major amount of Z-alkene. Similarly, when we have this PHO group attached here, it will also give us major amount of Z-alkene. Means it is also possible that we can get Z-alkene in this reaction. If in NET exam they will give you a simple type of phosphonate esters except these two, because it is given that they will give you Z-alkene. Except these two, if methyl phosphonate type of esters are given, then you have to form E-alkene only. So don't be confused with that. If in a NET exam they will give you ethyl phosphonate type of esters, or you they will give you methyl phosphonate type of ester, means this type of ester group is present, or if this type of ester group is present, then you have to generate E-alkene only, right? There is no confusion about it. Or it is also given in the book that if you have bulkier group like isopropyl group attached here, then it will also give you E-alkene. But these are some exceptions which is also mentioned to clarify that it is not necessary that you will always get a E-alkene, right? So to overcome this problem, they have generated a new reaction which is called Horner-Wittig reaction. What is Horner-Wittig reaction? That this time you are using phosphine oxide, that you simply have here phosphine oxide, right? Then we will take some very very important point about this reaction which you have to remember. First point is two type of diastereomers of beta hydroxy phosphine oxide are formed when it will react with this butyl lithium and this aldehyde. Two diastereomeric बीटा हाइड्रोक्सी फॉस्फीन ऑक्साइड विल फॉर्म. आई विल टेल यू हाउ दिस विल हैपन. दैट फर्स्ट वी आर यूजिंग दिस ब्यूटाइल लिथियम. सो इट इज सिंपल दैट वी हैव टू रिमूव ओनली अ प्रोटॉन फ्रॉम दिस पोजिशन. वी विल गेट नेगेटिव चार्ज हेयर. देन दिस नेगेटिव चार्ज विल अटैक ऑन दिस एल्डिहाइड. इट विल शिफ्ट हेयर. सो वॉट यू विल गेट दैट सपोज दिस इज दिस कार्बन. दिस वन आई विल राइट डाउन इट एज वन. दिस इज फर्स्ट कार्बन एंड दिस इज आर अटैच्ड हेयर. वी हैव दिस ग्रुप अटैच्ड एट दिस पोजिशन एंड दिस इज माई सेकेंड कार्बन ऑन दिस आर डैश ग्रुप इट अटैच्ड. एंड वेन दिस ऑक्सीजन विल दिस बॉन्ड विल शिफ्ट हेयर. दिस ऑक्सीजन विल गेट अ नेगेटिव चार्ज हेयर विद विच वन एच रिमूव फ्रॉम दिस पोजिशन विल अटैच एंड इट विल फॉर्म ओ एच. सो दिस इज योर बीटा हाइड्रोक्सी. दिस इज एल्फा कार्बन नेक्स्ट टू दिस पी डबल बॉन्ड ओ. दिस फॉस्फोरस एटम. दिस इज एल्फा. दिस इज बीटा. दिस इज बीटा हाइड्रोक्सी फॉस्फीन ऑक्साइड. सो यू विल गेट दिस टाइप ऑफ बीटा हाइड्रोक्सी फॉस्फीन ऑक्साइड. इन दिस केस दिस बॉन्ड इज अबव द प्लेन सपोज एंड दिस वन इज बिलो द प्लेन. वन पॉसिबिलिटी इज दिस वन. सेकेंड पॉसिबिलिटी इज that both of these bonds are on the same side like this one. So you will get two diastereomers of this beta hydroxy phosphine oxide. I hope this point is clear to you. Next is elimination step is stereospecific. Means only syn elimination. Only syn elimination will take place. Means these two groups should be on same side. Right? Means from this, you have to rotate this carbon to place this OH on the same side of this P double bond OPH group. Right? And when you will get rotated, you will get this R and R dash on the same side. Means Z alkene will form. Right? And when you do its elimination, these are already on the same side. So you will get E alkene like this. Right? So these are two important points. One more and very very important point is this is giving you two diastereomeric beta hydroxy phosphine oxide. Right? This point is clear. But out of these two, this anti form predominates. This one predominates. Right? Means major amount of Z alkene will form. Right? So if you want to generate this E alkene, what you have to do, that one possibility is you can react with this phosphine oxide first with butyl lithium, then you can treat it with some ester. Right? Now you can easily do this reaction, that you can write down it like this. This negative charge will attack here. This bond will shift. When it will come back, this part will be removed. This ethoxide will be removed. So you will get ketone here, ketonic group attached here. Means you will get this one, right? From this reaction, you will get this ketonic group attached next to it. Beta keto phosphine oxide will form. One possibility is this one. Other possibility is that if you treat with this anti beta hydroxy phosphine oxide, if you do its oxidation directly, then you will get this beta keto phosphine oxide. Then after this, you can treat this beta keto phosphine oxide with NaBH4, right? And then you will get this syn beta hydroxy phosphine oxide and it will give you E alkene, right? So this step is also clear. One more thing is here, that if you treating this beta keto phosphine oxide with this NaBH4, you have to be careful about this alpha carbon, which is chiral in nature, right? If the site of attachment of this group is given, that suppose it is above the plane and this is in the plane and H is below the plane, that you have to be careful about the stereochemistry of the group attached here. On the basis of that only, you have to decide that on which side your H minus will attach, right? You have to follow either Cram's rule or you can use Falkenhayn model. So I hope this part you can do, right? This is very simple, that you can easily find out that attachment side of these groups, and according to these two model you can decide the attachment side of H. So it will give you syn form, and then you can do rest part of the reaction, you can do syn elimination, and you will get E alkene. So out of all the reaction which we have discussed in Wittig reaction, I think this part is very, very important, because it involves a number of things which can confuse you. So I would suggest that please do practice of this part as much as you can, right? And I hope this video is helpful to you. I will finish this video here. In next part, I will come with more reaction. Thank you so much for watching. If you like my videos, please share my videos with your friend. Thanks again.